I think when you're talking about the quote ideal student, I think you're also talking about what someone's motivation is in order to take an online class. And if you're taking a class because you just want to know what the steps are in an algorithm to achieve a specific answer, my class is not for you, because I'm interested in helping the students understand why different things are true and how we can leverage that information to achieve our objectives. And so that's what I think that the students, I hope, gain out of the class, but that can also be some of their initial motivation coming in, is they really want to understand the whys, not just what are the steps, but why are they true and how we can use that. Because ultimately, to achieve our objectives, either for satellites around the Earth or for spacecraft going out into the solar system, we have to come up with new ideas and we have to think out of the box, and those future ideas are going to come from students who take classes like this and sort of learn how to understand and use the information about the path that the spacecraft could potentially have. So I think the online students who can contact us sometimes get a lot of feedback that is useful to them. I also experimented last year with opening a discussion board on my Blackboard site so that they could talk to other distant students, because some of them have the same challenges. And I think that was helpful. Some of them didn't want to use it, some of them did. But I try to set up times during the day when I'm available for calls, or my teaching assistant is, and some of them will tell me that they want to call and they'll call at this time. Some of them can't do that and we can make other arrangements. But I would like to interact with them. They don't have to do that, but I think it helps. It's also possible for them to send the question in advance and I can answer it on camera, or I can answer it to them personally in a separate venue. I did one student last year that I used Skype with so that we could actually see each other while we were having the conversation, and that's also great. But those questions are hopefully, I want them to have questions. If I give an assignment and they can all do it and they don't need me, they don't need anyone else's help, it's kind of like they already know it. So, you know, there's not always a lot of points. So I like to have things that are a little more thought-provoking, and the discussions can be very useful.